Good morning, kids and kids at heart. This morning, I'm going to be reading a book called What's in Your Bag from Jane Van Antwerp. And actually, a lot of the children's sermons I've already done have been books of hers, and some of you may already have these at home. So anyway, here we go. There is a great story in the Bible about a time when Jesus was teaching and more than 5,000 people gathered to listen. They loved learning from Jesus so much that they didn't want to leave, even when it got late and they were hungry. Jesus asked his disciples to find food for all the people, but they only found one boy who had brought a lunch. Only one lunch, but what was in the boy's bag was enough for Jesus. Jesus thanked God for the food and then had his disciples pass the boy's lunch out to all the people. Guess what? Not only was there enough for everyone, but there were leftovers. There are many stories recorded in the Bible about people sharing what they have and God using it to do amazingly big things. Like Esther, the story we've been talking about in church the last few Sundays. If she had a lunch bag, I wonder what would be in her bag that God could use. Let's see. A lion. The lion is a symbol of courage. And today, we're going to see how God uses Esther's courage to help save the Israelites. And God still works like that today. He uses one person who's willing to share what's in his or her bag to help others. So I'm curious, what's in other people's bags? What else God can use? And here in front of me, I have bags of people from our own church. So let's see. This bag is the lunch bag of PBF Kids. What's in there? It's our offering box from upstairs in kindergarten to fifth grade. You know, the money that our kindergarten fifth graders put in here goes to support Children of the Nation's Child Sponsorship Fund. God is using your offering to help 5,000 desperate kids in some of the poorest countries in Africa and the Caribbean. This bag belongs to Addie and Avery. There's a clock and a garden sprayer. Addie and Avery had an elderly neighbor who lived alone and didn't have many friends. So they spent time with her and they watered her plants for her. And God used these to help build a friendship that gave great joy to that neighbor. This is Zach's bag. Oh, Star Wars Lego set. Cool toy. You know, when Zach's younger brother had to be in the hospitals, it was kind of scary to see him hooked up to so many tubes. And that's when Zach got the idea to begin collecting toys to give to kids in the hospital so they wouldn't be as scared. Now God is using Zach's organization, Kids Helping Kids, to bring joy to thousands of children in local hospitals at Christmas time. Ivily. Let's see what's in her bag. Oh, it's a picture. It says, I'm praying for you with praying hands. You know, Ivily just learned the Lord's Prayer from memory, and she shared that prayer in a video that she sent to one of our small group leaders who's really sick. God is using Ivily's prayer to bring joy to Mr. Randy. No matter how old we are, God loves us to join in what he's doing by sharing what he's given us to those in need. So what do you have to share? What's your talent? What's in your bag that you can give away? Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for, oh man, the many ways that you have given us things. You've created us to be unique. and to offer what you've given to the world. Help us to do that. Whether it's our courage, our money, our time, our willingness to serve, things that we could give away, and our prayers. Lord, use those, and may we be your hands and feet in our neighborhoods, to our friends, and to the world this week. Amen. Well, if you head over to pbfkids.org, you'll see our Zoom link for kindergarten, fifth graders later today. We've got a new preschool video there, at family church activities. Have a good week.